Good evening, everybody. Thank you very much for joining us on this Thursday evening. It's quite a weird day, really. The update on the coronavirus, COVID-19, is nothing really new. It's just going up.
Yeah, it's very sad.
Very sad. Stop filming this too much.
Quick update on the hygiene front. Make sure that hands are clean. Both hands.
Your arms aren't very clean. What's in your arm?
Oh dear.
So this is part of a game.
Vanity.
If you swear, the word gets written on your limb.
For at least 20 seconds, wash your hands. Be honest, we're all fucked anyway, aren't we?
Ah.
Oh dear. That was genuinely not intentional.
Well, this is literally a live example.
Wherever you like.
Hi everyone, so welcome back to the bOSH cast number 3, diary number 3.
He's pissed.
No, I'm not. Washing your hands is probably one of the best things you can do.
Definitely.
David's hands are covered in fallacy and
so
rude
shame
words.
His neck.
Yeah, so is my neck. People won't get the disease if someone's carrying it and they go out, so just remember to stay indoors.
Yes, I would agree, absolutely agree. Wash your hands. Obviously, lockdown is imminent, I imagine. So just enjoy yourself. Try and be happy.
Just think of things to do inside, you
exactly.
know?
Exactly.
Think of ways to...
Keep interesting.
Yeah, to keep interested.
To keep busy. Rearrange a cupboard. Use your least dominant hand. I'm a right-handed man. I use my right hand to write.
But you want your... ass with your...
So my least dominant hand I would use to wipe my arse. However, I would recommend using a leaf or the Sun newspaper if you're that way inclined.
Or the Daily Mail. Any British newspapers. Hi there everyone, welcome back to the bOSH YouTube channel. We're here in the woods. And say, Dave, why don't we go to the pub?
No, it's illegal. Hello everybody, we're back in some form. I look a wreck because the snow's fucked my hair. Follow me.
Come on.
Well, this is what's known as a field. It's full of dead sort of fibres from leaves and animals, and it's made into this sludge called mud, which helps these things called plants to grow. It's their fertiliser, you see. Like when I eat a packet of Wotsits, it fills my need for sustenance. There is no better way to finish off the appearance of a landscape than with a massive pylon. Just a reminder that we're in lockdown, and
I thought at this time it's probably best to sort of give everybody really an update on the 2020 lifestyle. What have we all been up to? You know, has there been anything going on in the world?
Look what we've done to the world. Look what we've done. Look, I'm here on a hill, looking at people on a hill. Look at that. I'm on a hill. Looking at people on a hill. I'm on a hill.
Just a little thing I've noticed as we're walking up this hill, and the snow has turned to this kind of sludge falling from the sky. A metaphor, perhaps, for the year.
It's incredible. I'm on a hill and I can see people on a hill. Like, I am on a hill. I'm on a hill and I can see people on another hill. I'm on a hill and I can see people on another hill. Following on from Dave's rather insightful comments on nature earlier, I thought I'd do a bit on the different sort of trees that we have in this area of the United Kingdom. These traditional sort of pine trees. Now they're a coniferous tree, if I'm correct. They're different from a deciduous tree, as they have pines instead of large leaves. And the reason for this is because they don't need such a large surface area of leaf to collect sunlight and water. That's why they can grow in very, very cold and desolate climates. It's worth bearing in mind that, you know, trees, like humans, are sort of designed for various environmental.
Now, I believe in a year like 1400, perhaps, they invented the shoe. You can see that it's evolved. Now they're made of rubber and foul leather. I'm not...
Hang on.
Foul. Foe. They're now made of what seems to be some rubber, which did not exist in the 1400s. And this, which is a faux leather. I am unfortunately not rich enough to purchase the finest Chelsea leather. I don't know. I'm just talking about.
Hi, everyone. I've ruined my gloves. Something that has always eluded me was the thought of visiting the city of love, Paris, in France. I've always wanted to go there, and it's an absolute pleasure to be here now.
Je suis le pornographe du fun.
As Henry just said, we're in the city of love. Paris does look a bit different, but I guess that's what coronavirus does. Now, if you listen closely, you might not be able to pick it up on the old cellular phone. You can hear the buzz of electricity in the air as it cascades around the globe and our country. If you were to touch that wire, let me make something very, very clear. You would become dust. I'm going to be cooking some food tonight on the hob, powered by, I believe it's butane, Henry, is that correct?
Yeah, that's butane.
Butane,
yeah.
Right. If we ignited the butane incorrectly, we would be absolutely destroyed by it. This tent would be ignited, the surrounding tents would also be ignited. Hopefully that doesn't happen.
Sit rep, hob blew up.
Sorry, I'm trying to make sure I'm completely, abundantly transparent with you all. Because I think clarity is something we all desire at the moment. Because blonde bollock Boris ain't given us much. Basically, I want to reiterate, please do not ever, unless you desire death, caress the massive, thick wiring which protrudes from those pylons, because, and I say with no uncertainty, you will become, that's it, nothing.
I'd just like to thank Dave there for making that absolutely transparent and very, very clear that obviously touching one of the National Grid's electricity pylons will literally make you turn to ash. So it's wonderful that we've got that clarified, and we can now move on with the rest of the video. I'd like to thank you very much for watching from both of us here at the Bosch headquarters in the south of England. Thanks very much for watching. We'll see you soon. Stay safe.
All the weather outside is shit, and the fire is not yet lit. Since there's no place to go,
Let the snow turn to sludge and have a blow.